Birth defect surveillance programs ideally assess and describe birth defects occurring in an entire population. However, some surveillance programs can only collect birth defects data from selected hospitals. These are known as hospital-based birth defect surveillance programs. This video will provide an overview of the factors involved when using a hospital-based surveillance program to estimate birth defects prevalence in a selected population. Hospital-based surveillance programs collect data on birth defects from selected hospitals in a defined geographic area, such as a state, province, district, region, or county. A hospital can participate in surveillance if it is a facility with delivery services. If possible, surveillance programs should collect data on three pregnancy outcomes: live births, stillbirths, and elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly, which is abbreviated as ETOPFA. The ability to collect these pregnancy outcomes is based on the capacity of the health facility. For example, if a hospital does not have prenatal diagnosis available, identifying a fetus affected with a birth defect will not be possible. Further, if terminations of pregnancy are not legal in a country, it will be difficult or impossible to collect elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly. Finally, if a hospital does not collect information on stillbirths, a stillborn with a birth defect will not be identified or captured. When calculating prevalence, if a stillbirth, elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly, or live birth with a birth defect occurs in a participating hospital, it should be captured and included in the surveillance program. The residence of the mother is not an inclusion criterion. If a stillbirth, elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly, or live birth with a birth defect does not occur in a participating hospital, it is not included in the program. Some cautions should be noted when using hospital-based data to calculate prevalence. First, if home births are common in a population and only hospital-based data are collected, there could be an underestimation of birth defects prevalence. Second, the types of hospitals participating in the surveillance program can affect which patients are served and thus counted. For example, a hospital might be well known for its obstetric services, and therefore many women might opt to deliver there. Further, a hospital located in a lower income area might serve a population of women with a unique set of risk factors. Another problem related to the type of hospital is if the hospital offers prenatal diagnosis and/or provides treatment services for patients identified with birth defects. Referral patterns to this type of hospital can increase the likelihood that an affected stillbirth, elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly, or neonate with a birth defect is delivered in such a specialized medical center. This means that the patient population of specialty medical centers might disproportionately include more stillbirths, elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly, and/or neonates with birth defects than would otherwise be identified or delivered if that hospital was not a referral center. This creates what is known as referral bias. Fourth, data collected by hospitals about birth defects might only be able to capture birth defects obvious at birth. Because neonates are typically discharged from delivery hospitals within days following birth, some hospital-based programs include only those birth defects that are captured during the hospital stay, unless a longer age of inclusion is specified in the surveillance program. Finally, neonates identified after discharge from a delivery hospital are only included if they were born at a participating site and if they met the case inclusion criteria. Babies with a birth defect born at home will never be included in a hospital-based program, regardless of the time of diagnosis. Despite these considerations, to estimate total prevalence in a hospital-based birth defect surveillance program, first, count the number of live births, stillbirths, and elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly with birth defects occurring in the participating hospitals within a given period of time. This is the numerator. Note that stillbirths, elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly, or neonates with birth defects who are delivered at home are never included in hospital-based surveillance, even if they are identified and captured later by a participating hospital. Also remember, the mother's residency does not affect which births are counted in a hospital-based program. Next, count the total number of deliveries, which would include live births, elective terminations of pregnancy for fetal anomaly, and stillbirths that occur in participating hospitals within the same period of time. This is the denominator. Last, divide the numerator by the denominator and then multiply the result by 10,000. In this example, you have determined that the hospital-based prevalence of birth defects is 125 cases per 10,000 births, or 1.3%, for a particular time period. In summary, hospital-based pregnancy outcomes can be used to estimate and describe the prevalence of birth defects in a hospital or groups of hospitals over a period of time. This type of system is called hospital-based birth defect surveillance program.